Instead of having p squared threads to compute p squared force interactions and then summing them up between threads, we'll only use p threads total. Each of these p threads will then be responsible for p interactions. Another way to think about it is that one thread, this horizontal thread here, is responsible for applying the force of all p source objects to one destination object. So the code for this is really simple, and we're showing it here. Our kernel code simply loops n over p times over this particular routine. It accumulates p by p interactions onto p threads in each iteration. So what's happening in this code? Well, the input to the kernel is my parameters, those associated with my destination object. Those would be, say, your position and your mass or your charge, and the accumulated force that has acted on my object so far. And the output will be the accumulated force after I add in p more interactions, one for each of the source objects with which I'm interacting. So we assume that we store the parameters for the p source objects in shared memory, source params here. And then we just loop p times over those p objects. We compute the interaction, and this might be computation of gravitational force, it might be electrostatic force, and the params will differ depending on what kind of force it is. And then we'll compute the interaction and add the resulting force into the force accumulator variable and return it.